I know the key in here. I know the key in here. Oh! Oh! I should draw this shit, boy. Kiss the game goodbye. Come on. Really make me root. Oh.
What are you doing? What the fuck? What the fuck are you doing, man?
Yo, it's a joke, man.
Queens, we play too much, man.
Yo, 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 yo. It's your boy, Uneducated Brother. You know how we do it out here in these streets, man. And today, man, yo. This video right here is a special video. And I want you guys to understand this. Everything that these white people are doing that's like, you know, considered white supremacists, right? It's exactly what these rich black people are doing, all right? So if you look at a typical white rich person, right? He rich, he live in a gated community, and sometimes he may have, you know, a gun on him, practicing the Second Amendment. Oh, wait. Let me cut this video off and give you this sponsor. Well, not even a sponsor. I'm just so hype about this shirt right here that I got on. Shout out to my goons right here. You know, run up, get done up. Because you don't want to approach anybody crib thinking that you can just invade it. Because if you do that, you got motherfuckers like this showing they got guns ready to defend themselves. Now, let's get back to regularly scheduled program. The reason why all this shit ties all into the mix, just like this sponsor that I spoke about, my nigga DJ Envy did exactly the same thing that nigga did. Well, not that. These niggas. I call them niggas because, you know, this is just the common language in the black community. Everybody is a nigga. A man is a nigga, a female is a bitch. This is how we talk. You know how it is out here in these streets, man. So, right now, everybody was giving this nigga heat. My man right here was giving that nigga mad heat. Oh, you know, white supremacists, you know. Oh, he's gonna pull guns out on his protesters because, you know, they bombarded his gated community or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, hold on. These niggas out here, you know what I'm saying, coming into your hood, unannounced, and you live in a secure gated area, how you expect to react when motherfuckers do that shit? You know what I'm saying? And the media painted these motherfuckers as bad. But wait, what about this motherfucker right here?
Yeah, Queen Flo, I'm here. Whatever he thought, I wasn't coming. What he thought? He thought I wasn't coming. Get out of here. I'm from Queens, man. Yeah, I want to move to Jersey. Woo! The Roseburg and the McClendon. Hey, how much you want to bet he got these cars over there? How much you want to bet? I bet you this is locked. Look, weirdo. What I said, I know what I'm talking about. Hold on. I know the key in here. Oh. I should draw this shit, boy. Kiss the game goodbye. Come on. Oh.
What are you doing? What the fuck are you doing, man?
Yo, it's a joke, man.
Queens, we play too much, man. Don't come to my fucking crib, my nigga.
It's a joke,
man. My nigga, don't come to my fucking crib. Are you crazy, my nigga?
You challenge me.
My nigga, get the fuck. My nigga, are you serious?
You gonna shoot me?
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot you, nigga. You come in my fucking get you in my car.
You challenge me, nigga!
You in my fucking car, you crazy?
You crazy? No, put that. What? Put that down. Put that down. Put that down. You got my son right here. You got my son.
My nigga, leave.
No, open the gate for me.
My nigga, leave.
Open the gate.
How'd you get over here?
I climbed the gate.
Climb the shit back over.
No.
Climb the shit back
over. No. I want that verse.
I got something for you.
I want that verse. What you got for me? I'm coming to your crib.
I got something for you. I got something for you.
So put that down. Put that down. Put that down. You got my son here. You violating. My son is here.
I got something.
You a family man.
I got something.
Don't point that at me.
I got something.
I'm going to your crib. Don't lock that door. I'm coming to your crib.
See? Now, you see how this whole shit just played out, right? My man Queens Flip hopped over the gate to go check out his boy DJ Envy. And what DJ Envy did, he came out strapped, just like these motherfuckers did.
Tonight, the couple seen in this now viral video is detailing what they say was strictly self-defense. Mark McCloskey and his wife stood on their patio Sunday night, pointing guns at a crowd of protesters.
I was terrified that we'd be murdered within seconds, that our house would be burned down, that our pets would be killed.
McCloskey says he and his wife called 911 and grabbed their guns as they heard the crowd approaching from afar. Video from another angle shows protesters chanting while walking into their private gated community, which appears to be open. But McCloskey says the key is required and later shared these photos of the gate destroyed.
I stood up and announced loudly, "This is private property. Please go back, leave." As soon as I said the words private property, it enraged the crowd. There was then a horde of people coming through the broken gate.
And it's like, hold on. You mean to tell me these rich black people are living exactly like the white people? You know, like Charlemagne said in the other video, talking about some, yo, I got armed guard that'll legally pop you. Ain't nobody gonna chant your name. Nigga, I am a tax-paying, law-abiding citizen, and I protect myself as such. It is like, what? Can I get the same privilege as a normal citizen? Because if you got bodyguards around you, and DJ Envy got some type of futuristic gun, I never saw this shit ever. This shit looked like some shit out of Call of Duty. I was about to say Call of a Duty. My bad. I only play zombies in Call of Duty, so. Yo, it's like, bruh. Huh? He did exactly what this nigga did. And nobody's calling him out for that? And the crazy shit about it, right? He was about to pop one of his own peoples. Now imagine, right? If he just, boom, ain't even give a fuck. He just started blasting at the car, right? Before he went to see who it was. Then what y'all niggas would have said, huh? Oh yeah, that shit was rightful. Just like if these niggas, right, just started blasting at the protesters, right? Then what y'all niggas would have said? Oh, white supremacists, and this is why we should definitely take out the Second Amendment. Eliminate all these niggas away from their guns. Not realizing the guns is the only thing that's keeping the criminals away from you. They never talk about the criminals. Elite motherfuckers with that live in gated communities and they got guns, they never talk about criminals. Why? Because they don't see them niggas at all. Wait till the motherfuckers come to their house and you see how they get treated. See what happened in the Queens Flip video. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, don't follow these motherfuckers' words. Just follow their actions. And based on their action, they are showing you that they are for themselves. Just like that Marxist lady, the BLM Marxist lady. She's for herself and hers. Hers and hers. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, yo, they are preaching, oh, we for everybody. Equity, equity. Why they all of them looking out for themselves? What happened to the equity? Since you collected all the damn bread, right? Why don't you give back to the rest of the community? And how about this? Matter of fact, not even give back. Why don't you just move to the communities that you're, like, champion for? That you're saying that it's under oppressed, that is oppressed, I mean. Why don't you just move there? Why? You want to live in white people neighborhoods. You want to live in gated communities like DJ Envy. You know what I'm saying? It's like Charlemagne. All these niggas live around white people. I guarantee you on that. Now, right? If you really about that life, yo, for these, you know, woke motherfuckers, I hate these woke niggas because these motherfuckers are the most deceitful motherfuckers ever. Test a motherfucker to see if he's really woke or not. When a nigga get rich, see where he move at. And then, before he even make that move, right? force him to stay in his motherfucking community. See what he'll say. I don't even know what he'll say. But that nigga is not dumb enough to live in a high crime area, which is predominantly populated by us. And we gotta do something about that. And we ain't doing nothing about it. We just crying out to the white man, right? Oh, we're needing help from the white man. Just remember, when the white man help you, he'll forever be your master. And you'll forever be his slaves. Someone who owes a debt to someone is someone's master. If I owe a debt, well, I am a... If someone who owes a debt to someone is someone's slaves, I am a slave to my debt. So that means that I have to work my 9-to-5, right, just to pay off this debt. So this 9-to-5 that I'm doing, right, I'm doing it under this motherfucking debt collector so I can be free, financially be free. Now, if you have a system, systematic racist system that you're begging to free you, what do you think they're gonna feel about you when you become free? They ain't gonna feel free, because they gonna look at you like, yeah, nigga, you owe me. It's your boy, Uneducated Brother. You know how we do it out here in these streets, man. Until next time, one out. Bad boy, baby.
Thug life. Thug life. Thug life. That's my cousin.